The South Dakota State men's basketball team finished the first half of Summit League play last Wednesday at Denver. TJ Otzelberger's squad was efficient offensively, shooting 49% from the field, but they allowed 15 offensive rebounds to the Pioneers, which led to 22 second chance points, and SDSU fell 91-82.
Yeah, I think we started out defensively. We weren't quite as engaged as we needed to be, and they got off to a little bit of a run early in that game. And then what happened for us is we tried to play from behind. Our guys did a good job offensively executing and making shots, but too many times down the stretch, we had a pretty good defensive possession, didn't secure the rebound, and I think they had like six offensive rebounds over the last, you know, 6 or 7 minutes of the game. So it prevented us from kind of getting over the hump, and we could never really pose a serious threat to them. So we've just got to be more prepared from the start and our energy level, and we've got to do a great job down the stretch finishing plays.
On Saturday, the Jackrabbit men traveled to Omaha to play the second game of a doubleheader versus the Mavericks. SDSU played an inspired game without second leading scorer A.J. Hess, shooting 50% from the field and out-rebounding Omaha by 15 en route to an 88-84 win.
I was really happy with their effort, especially losing A.J. Hess with the dislocated elbow in the Denver game. We've talked a lot about everybody being ready and playing for the team, and really just thought it was a gritty, gutsy performance by our guys. They just overall played with such a great amount of heart. We're so tremendous on the glass to out-rebound Omaha 38-23. We needed every one of those effort plays and just couldn't have been more proud of our guys after that game.
Without A.J. Hess, there was a bit of an unknown of who would step up for SDSU, but Lane Severin and Chris Howell stepped up to the occasion. Severin logged 11 points and 7 rebounds, while Howell scored 16, including 8 of the team's first 10 points, and he logged 6 boards.
Now, Chris did a great job, especially early in the game, attacking the basket, putting pressure on the rim, and phenomenal job. And his rebounds were big, those free throws at the end with just over 10 seconds to go. We're counting on Chris now, and he really stepped up for us. And with Lane Severin, his energy has really transcended our team. He's done an unbelievable job on the glass. He dives for loose balls. He's physical. His toughness has taken us to a whole nother level. And he knocked down 3 big threes, had a great tip dunk, huge energy play, so really proud of Lane.
This year is one of the most unpredictable years in recent memory for the Summit League. Third place in the conference, a 5-4 record, is only 2 games ahead of ninth place at 3-6. Such a tight race places an extra emphasis on how important each game is, especially since every team is capable of winning against anyone.
You know, every night out, anybody can beat anybody, and you're seeing that throughout league play across the conference, whether it's home and road. There's such a great amount of parity and balance throughout the league, so every night teams have to be at their best, and I think ultimately when you see in the standings is the teams that can prove to be the most consistent are probably going to be the ones that continue to rise to the top, because you can't have any off night. Everybody's playing at a high level, and teams are going to beat you if you're not at your best.
The Jacks are back in action this week for a pair of games at home. On Wednesday, Western Illinois enters Frost Arena. SDSU will look to avenge their 82-74 loss in Macomb 4 weeks ago, starting with better defense on the Leatherneck guards.
You know, Western Illinois, they're 4-5 in league play. Robert Covington's a guy who's been right around a 20-point-a-game scorer through league play throughout his career, really playing at a high level. They play 4 guards. They can really shoot the basketball. They're a team that, you know, if you lose shooters, they've been a team that's made 18, 19 threes in games. So you've got to do a great job keeping them in front of you and making sure you locate shooters and don't let them get going from three.
On Saturday, Jackrabbit Athletics will have a triple header inside Frost Arena in the 25th annual Lamb Bonanza. The SDSU men will host Oral Roberts in that game at 4:30 p.m., a team that the Jacks lost 94-88 3 weeks ago. Albert Owens caused problems for Otzelberger's squad, going off for 24 points and 9 rebounds, so stopping the Golden Eagle big man will be a focus heading into Saturday's contest.
You know, Oral Roberts is a physical interior team. I think after Mike Dom, Albert Owens might be the best scoring big in league play, and they really try to play with 2 bigs and pound it inside. So, again, we felt like down there with a minute 20, it's a tie game. We didn't get the possessions we needed to get down the stretch to come out with a victory, and hopefully we can go into this week with a similar mindset that we did against Omaha, as we have an opportunity to avenge 2 losses of games that we were right in the game and didn't finish the job. And I think if we go in with the mindset of that this is the most important game of the year, play as hard as we can, really try to win that war on the rebounds, that we can come out successful. And hopefully we'd start with one on Wednesday and then build on that going into Saturday.